गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम यू टू स्टेट लाइव लेक्चर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, दैट इज क्लास 9। सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रेड। वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट इज ट्रेड। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द पार्ट 2 ऑफ द ट्रेड। But before that, let's revise what we have studied in the first session. Yes, in the first session we have studied the concept as well as the definition of the trade. Yes, what is the definition? That buyers and sellers buy and sell the goods respectively. This is called the trade. This was the definition of the trade. And to explain it in more concept, I asked you all to take the screenshot of that diagram. Yes, to explain the proper concept of trade. After that, we have studied about the two simple types of trade, that was invisible trade and visible trade. Visible trade means what? The product which are physically we are buying it, we can see the product, like for example vegetables, fruits or any products that we can see and we can hold it in our hand, that is known as visible trade. And invisible trade means what? Invisible trade means where there is a exchange of services. For example, doctors, teachers, lawyers, these are the invisible trade. Yes, then we have studied, which you can see on your screen, the main type of trade, this one, types of trade. The first one we have studied on the basis of quantity of goods. In that, wholesale trade and retail trade. Yes, we are revising, students, what we have learned in the first session. Yes, then yes, the first type of trade, that was according to the quantity of the goods and which classified into two, was wholesale trade and retail trade. In wholesale trade means what? In wholesale trade, it depends, the quantity should be more over there. Yes, the traders, they buy the products on a very large scale, directly brought the products to the wholesale market. And the commodities means the products which are sold on large scale to retail traders. This is called the wholesale trading. Yes, this is called as the wholesale trading. Wholesale traders buy goods on large scale from industrialists, farmers, etc. Farmers, what they did, the product is being produced over there by the farmers. That time, the farmers, they all together, the product which are being produced, they get it, they brought it, and they get it to the wholesale market. And there, you can see the images also on your screen. The products which are there in the wholesale market, and that time, after that, the retail, means the small shops, where they are getting the this products, they are getting it from the wholesale market. Yes, then second was about the retail trader. Retail trader means what? In your area, you can see the vegetable vendors, they are sitting on the footpath, and also the small shops you can see. Those are known as the retail traders. Yes, from where they get these products, they get it from the wholesale market. Yes, and they sell it in their shop. But here, one thing you have to see, student, in wholesale market, you get the product on a very large scale. And in the retail trader, in retail trade, you get the quantity of the goods are very less. This was about the retail trading. Yes. So, as we have completed this first part of the, this part we have done. Let's move on to the second type of trade. That we are, this also we have studied in the first session, but we have to we are going to revise it on the basis of extent of trade region, that is domestic or internal trade, domestic or internal trade, and the second is international or external trade. One by one we'll see. Yes, according to the extent of region, the buying and selling of goods happens at various levels. Yes, on that basis, trade is divided into regional, national, and international trade. So here, first you understand that buying and selling, this two process, it happens on a various levels. First is regional level, second national and international level. Regional level means into the region only they are selling the product, and national means the product is, the product is being sell to the all over the nation, is known as a national trade. And international trade means when we are trading with other countries, we are crossing the borders of a country, that is known as the international trade. Next, what is domestic trade? Domestic trade means within the trading which takes place between region, but the country is same. That is known as the domestic trade. Domestic trade is also known as internal trade. Then international trade means exchanging of goods and services. Goods and services from one country to other country, that is known as international trade. For that, in the international trade, we have two types of trade also: bilateral trade and multilateral trade. Bilateral trade means what? Only trading is taken between two countries, that is known as bilateral trade. And multilateral trade means more than two countries are involved in the trading system, it is known as multilateral trade. Yes. Then we have studied about the export and import. Export and import are the main process, are the basic process of the international trading. Yes, when a country buys the goods and services which are scarce in their own country from another country, it is known as import. Yes, whenever in some other country, if the product is not available, there is very scarcity over there, not enough good is available in that country, then we have to take it, we have to import the goods to our country. That is known as the import. Means to the product is getting into our country to get in, that is known as import. And export means what? In any other country or in any other region, the product is very much enough. Yes, means in a more quantity we are getting it in another country. That time that country is exporting their goods to other countries. Means they are exporting, means they are selling the product to other countries. Yes, this was about the import and export. Yes. So here now, just now what we have done, we have revised what we have studied in the first chapter. Sorry, in the first part. So let's continue the second part of the trading, trade lesson. Yes. Right now what we have learned about the import and export. Yes. Now import and export, how it is happened in the at the international level, there are some organizations also we are going to study in this. Now here on here you can see over here, it's all about balance. One side you can see self means we are there, and other side you can see the family, education, friends, work, money. Yes, that time the head of the person have the head of the person, he has to balance all the things. Yes, it should be, sometimes it goes up and down like a seesaw. Yes, students, the same like that, the balance of the trade is also important in our country, because there are some values in a specific period. The economic activity of our country is, you can say, there is a very important value where we have to consider. So here, let's start the part two, new topic, that is balance of trade. Yes, so this balance of trade, the difference between the import and export values of a country in a specific period is called balance of trade. Following are the types of balance of trade. When the value of imports when the value of imports is more than the value of export, it is called unfavorable balance of trade. So first we'll see the what is the import and export. Import and export, just now we have revised what is import and export. If you can see, if the import is more, the imports quantity is also more. Yes, if the product is being import in a very large, on a very large scale, that time you can see the export is less over there. Then that is unfavorable trade. The balance is not good for the country. Yes, here we are learning the types of trade over there. The first type is unfavorable balance of trade. When in the unfavorable means what? When the value of the import is more, which you can see the image on your screen. The value of the import is more and then the value of export is very less. That time we can say that is unfavorable balance of trade. Second, when the value of export is more than the value of import, it is called favorable balance of trade. Next is what? When here in the favorable balance of trade, we can see the value of export is more than the value of import. Yes, it is vice versa. Then this is favorable balance of trade. Third type of balance. Third type, it is when the value of import as well as export is almost same. You can see here, almost the import and export, it is same. That time you can see that is balanced balance of trade. You can see the balance is very appropriate over there. It is exactly the same. That time this type of balance we can say over there, that is balanced balance of trade. This was the three types of balance of trade. First was unfavorable, favorable, and third is balanced trade. Yes. Next. Now here, just now I told you about there are some organizations that we have to know it at the international level. So the main headquarters of the head office of international organization, that is everybody knows about this, that is WTO, World Trade Organization. But there are a few more headquarters in our countries also, in other countries also. There are, and the other, each organization, their aims, functions are very different, that we are going to see. So before that, we will study this International Trade Organization. There are some few points that we have to focus on it. First point, Carrying out trade at an international level is more complex process than domestic. Yes, when we are trading in the domestic level, at the domestic level means the internally in one country only, when we are sending the product, it's not so complex. Yes, but when we are trading at international level, that is more complex over there. Yes, why? Because there are some papers that you have to clarify before when we are product is being send it to other country. Second point here, see. Trade takes place between two or more nations. Factors like the economy of the country, government policies, market law, judicial system, currency, language, etc. influence the trade. See, if we want to do the trading in to the international level, that time all these factors we have to see, and then the trading is done over there. First factor is what economy of the country. Then there are some government policies that we have to go through it. Market laws. Yes, there are some market laws also. Means at a then judicial system, currency, languages. These are the factors which are very influenced when we are trading at the international level. Third point. Third point, the political relations between the two countries also influence the trade between them. Sometimes the obstacles in the way of trading affect the mutual relationship adversely. When the trading is done between two countries, that time there are some political relations also, it may differ, students. And because of that, there are some obstacles also in the way of trading, and which can affect their mutual relationship also. Then, next point. To avoid this, International Economic and Trade Organization came up. So, because of these reasons, yes, because of this reason about the mutual relationship will affect, because of the, there are some political relations which affects with one or two other countries in between them. So because of this reason, they tried to avoid by implementing trade organization and international economy. To smoothen and justify the process of trade between countries of different economic standing, some international economic organizations were formed. Means to the process of the trading and at international level should be very smoothly, it should be go, and the whatever the process should be clarified by all the peoples. So because of that, this international economic organizations were formed, and the trading which is going to happen between two or more countries, that should be very clearly, it should be done and a very smoothly. So because of this international economic organizations were formed. These organizations work together the facilitation and growth of international trade. This organization, there are many more organizations that we are going to see here. These organizations, they work together, and their main aim is to the growth of the international trade. Then, this was the introduction of the international trade organizations. Now we are going to see the two organizations. Here you can see on your screen. The headquarters of ASEAN, its full form is Association of Southeast Asian Nations. This one. And the second is head office, you can see the World Trade Organization. These are the two international trade organizations of the world. Then, Now we are going to learn one by one all the organizations of the world, which is taking at the international place. Yes. This chart is also there in your textbook, student. You can refer it. If you have, you can open your textbook to note down the notes. The first is about the World Trade Organization. That is its full form of WTO. Number of member states and its logo you can see. Number of members are 164, and the headquarters and its country is Switzerland, and headquarters is in Geneva. Then the first point you can see, there are some aims and functions of it. You can see the first point here: to provide platform for negotiation in international trade. Negotiation means what? Negotiation means to talk or to discuss. It is known as a negotiation. This World Trade Organization, they provide the platform that there are some points to be discussed. Means they are giving opportunity to everybody, opportunity to speak with different countries in the world. That is known as the negotiation. Second is to handle the differences related to trade. Monitor the trade policies of member states, providing technological assistance and training to developing countries. This, they handle it in a very different, in a different way, all which is related with the trade. And they also monitor all the trade policies of the member states, and they provide the training also to other developing countries that how the training should be done at international level. Second is about the European Union, that is EU. See the students, this name of the International Trade of Organization, you have to study in detail, because some other questions for 2 marks they may ask. Okay, and the full form also you have to learn it. You can see the number of states, 28, its logo, European Union. The country it is in Belgium. Here it is establishment and integrated market amongst member nations in Europe. There is a free flow of goods and services. Custom duties have been cancelled on the exchange of goods within the members. Common euro currency established. These are the functions of the European Union. The next is Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, that is OPEC. You can see the logo, it's in Australia. These are the functions over here. Controlling the international trade of crude oil, controlling the rates of crude oil production among member states, maintaining constants in oil export. Now here you can see the new word over here, consensus. It is known as approved or approval. And the crude oil, yes, see this one, controlling the rates of crude oil production among the member states. Crude oil means what? You can say the petroleum, diesel or kerosene, that is known as about the crude oil. So this country, it's this organization, it trading is done of crude oil, and they are having control also over to it. Then next is SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. 8 members are there. The logo you can see, it's in Nepal. And its headquarters, it is in Kathmandu. Their aims is Finding satisfactory solutions to the common problems faced by countries in South Asia, increasing social welfare, raising the living standard, and increasing regional cooperation among member states to remove unrest in South Asia. Then, Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Yes, this one. These two are the repeated one. The 10 members are there. The logo you can see, it's in country, it is Indonesia. Expanding social and cultural harmony along with the economic growth in SE Asia, promoting regional peace, promoting tax waivers for trade organization in member states. Then it is Asia Specific Economic Cooperation, that is APEC. Here also 21, it's in Singapore, and there are two aims over here. Then next is about the Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa, that is known as BRICS. It's in China. These are the aims that we have to go through it. Yes, after this economic organization of the world, let's move on to the next topic, that is about the marketing. Here, introduction we'll see first about the marketing. With a lot of hard work, yes, there is a activity over here. Yes, a small story they have given here, student, about the person Dhondiba. Used to grow the best varieties of vegetables and other agricultural commodities, but his product could not fetch a good price. This is the person who is doing the farming over there. And he used to grow the best variety of vegetables and other agricultural product also. But when he used to, when he was selling his products, he was not getting a good price over there. Yes, then his college son saw the situation, and he first packed the commodities nicely after cleaning them neatly. Then Dhondiba's son was there. He was a college student. That time he saw the situation and he packed the products very nicely. He cleaned it very, and he kept in a very proper way that product. Then he contacted the supermarket in the town. Looking at the quality of his product, they advertised the farm product and kept it for sale in the mall. Then, today Dhondiba's commodities are being sold for a higher price than before. Yes, what happened here, what we can see, firstly, Dhondiba's product was not getting a good price over there, because there was no, the product was not in contact in a very proper way. When his son saw the situation, what he did, the product has been packed properly. Then he contacted with the supermarket, the nearest town he saw. He contacted the supermarket, the main person of the supermarket. That time he took that product and he gave it to that man. That time the farm product, and he kept it for the sale in the mall. And the advertising was also done over there. That time after this, Dhondiba's product was in demand over there. That time he was getting a very high price for all his agricultural product. So here what we have understood that if any product is sold to the retailer or a wholesaler, you have to see the product and their quality as well as the marketing values also. An appropriate presentation of any commodity is indispensable. If any product presentation we are doing in a very proper way, that time we can say that is the marketing we are doing on of the product. Second, the price of the commodity is determined by its quality, its grading, and how it is presented before the customer. The price of the product is determined, we can see it by its quality, its grading system, yes, and about the how we are presenting in front of the customer, that also differs. Dhondiba's commodities lacked this. Dhondiba's son recognized it and adapted necessary changes on time. Here the Dhondiba's product was good, but the product is not being sold properly. That time the situation, Dhondiba's son, he saw it, he recognized it, and he has done some necessary changes. What necessary changes he has done? The product has been cleaned properly, he packed properly, and in a neat way he kept in the mall. Thus, when we take similar measures for industrial and agricultural product, then the value of commodity increases from the customer's view. When we take same in an industrial as well as in the agricultural product, the value of the product increases from the customer's view. When we can say the product is very neatly packed, price is disabled over there, as well as the quality is also good and the presentation of the product is also good, that time we can say the customer's view has been changed over there. Then, thus the product fetches a good price and also demand for the product increases. If that product is from the customer view, that product is a very nice product, that time the product of that price we are going to get it and the demand will also increase. Then next is about the importance of the marketing. So here what we have studied, whenever we want to sell the product, we have to go through some marketing policies over there. Marketing means what? Marketing means it is the promotion of business products or services to target the audience, and an action taken to bring attention to a business offerings. Yes, it is known as the marketing. Marketing means what? It is a promotion of business products or services to target the audience. It is known as the marketing. Now we are going to see the why marketing is very important, that we are going to see. First point, the existence of marketing system for trade is very important. Through marketing, one can increase business systematically. The production can be distributed all at once on a large scale. The product can reach a large number of consumers. The selling price of the product also increases. Also, defective products can be recalled from the market. Therefore, in today's era, marketing is a vital part of the trading system. Here, what they have said here, the marketing system is very important when we are doing the trading. When the trade is taking place, marketing is also very important over there. Then through marketing, the one type of, you can say the business is automatically, it is increased. And the product's production is done on a very large scale. Then the same product is being reached in various countries also, as well as number of customers, there is a demand for that product because of the marketing. The selling price of the product also increases. Also, the defective products can be recalled from the market. Therefore, in today's era, this marketing process is very important in the trading system. Then, next. In recent times, information technology and media have affected the marketing systems deeply. In today's era, students, information technology and media, they are affecting the marketing systems deeply. Means the online shopping, you can say. These apps, Flipkart, Reliance Smart, Amazon. Yes, all this, they are, this latest technology, this apps, with this app, the marketing systems, it affects deeply over there. Then because of the revolution in the field of information technology, the whole market has become a big market. Through internet, we can get information about the productions taking place in various countries. This makes numerous options available to the customers. For example, due to use of internet facilities, the customers, they can do the online trading also, as well as e-marketing also. In our 21st century, you can see the most of the customers, they are using the latest technology. Due to this latest technology, the marketing system is very on much, means its demand is very, it's too much, students, for the consumers, the customers, they are getting the product. They can easily see their advertisement on the internet and they can buy it online also. This was the marketing system. Why it is important, they have mentioned over here. Then, next is, yes. So, here was the second part of the trade, that is import and export, and about the trading system, and as well as the marketing system also. Then here we are going to revise what we have studied. Yes, so let's revise from the first what we have studied in the first part also, in the first session. Firstly, we have studied the definition of trade. Definition of trade means is what? Here, in the first, we have studied the definition, that was buyers and sellers. And the buyers and sellers, they buy and sell the goods on respectively, that is known as trade. Then we have studied visible and invisible trade, the two types. Then second was, third point is about the main types of trade. You can see the image also here. The two types of trade, it is classified into two. Yes, first is on the basis of quantity of goods, and second is on the basis of extent of trade region. First, it was about the wholesale trade, and second is about retail trade. Wholesale trade means what? In this trade, at a very large amount of goods we can buy. Yes, and in the wholesale market, the producers means the products who are producing the product, they directly are on a large scale, directly it is being brought it from the producers in the wholesale market. Yes, then from the wholesale market, the product is being moved forward to the retail traders. I mean, the retail traders means the traders which buy the goods from wholesale traders, and they sell it to the customers. Means the nearby shops you can see in your area, that is known as retail trade. Second is on the basis of extent of trade region. There are the two trade over there, domestic or internal trade. Second is international or external trade. Domestic trade means the trading which is done within the same country but different region. Trading is done within the same country but the region is different. And international trade means what? The goods are exchanged from one country to other country, that is known as international trade. Next, import and export. Here we have studied about the import and export. These two are the basic process of international trade. Yes, when a country buys goods and services which are not there in the country, which are the scarcity of the product is there in, yes, in their own country, then we are buying the product from other country, it is known as import. And export means what? When a country produces excess number of goods, that time if other country requires the product over there, that time we are selling it to the other country and they are demanding for it, that is known as export. Then it is about the balance of trade. Balance of trade means what? With the example we have studied, it's of the seesaw. There should be balance between import and export. In that, we have studied the three types of balance. First was unfavorable, second was favorable, and third was balance trade. In the first, what we have studied, when the value of import is more, yes, when the product is input more than the export, that is known as unfavorable balance. Then second was about the favorable trade. The value of export is more than the value of import. Yes, the product is being exported more than the import. It is known as favorable. Here we are talking, students, about the value of the goods. Value of the goods means the price of the goods, which here we are earning more and more money because of the export in the value of product. That was about the favorable balance of trade. Next is about third balance, that is balanced trade. Means here value of export and import is almost same, is known as balanced trade. Next we have studied international trade of organization. Yes, about the WTO, World Trade Organization, its member and its logos also. Yes, and there are different aims and function of each and every organization. Its main functions are different. But then we have studied, first we studied WTO, World Trade Organization. Second, European Union. Then OPEC, third was Organization of Petrol and Petrol Exporting Countries. Then SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. That was about the SAARC. Then fifth was about Association of Southeast Asian Nations. That is ASEAN. Next is Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation, APEC. Last was about the BRICS, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. These are the international trade organizations with their different aims and functions. Then last topic was about the marketing and its important we have studied. Before going into the marketing, there was a small story they have given about the farmer, that is Dondiba and his sons. Here in the marketing, what we have studied, if we want to have a good quality product, also its advertisement affects us. Yes, everyone doesn't possess, or everyone doesn't know about each and every product. But when we see others are using that product, or when we are seeing the advertisement about that product, when we do the inquiry about it, that time we see that product in the market, and the product is available in the market, and here there is a need for that product for us, then we buy it. And all this is possible because of the marketing. Means a good marketing promotes the business also of the product. So the importance of the product in what we have studied, when we buy vegetables from street, yes, we get the cost of the vegetable or any fruit is less. Yes, this is the in the same product. When we buy fruits or vegetables from the mall, yes, we get it in a very high price over there. Their price is very more over there. Why it is more? Because the product is being packed properly, means the fruits are being packed in a very good quality of box. The label is also done properly. Packing is also done properly. It looks very attractive. So the product of that, the fruit price is also more over there. As we are getting it, the same product we are getting at the vegetable vendors also. Yes, in the vegetable market. But the same product you can see in the mall also. But in the mall, the price of that fruit is high because of the packing and about the marketing policies, the price is more and the product it looks very attractive over there. So this was about the importance of marketing. Yes. This was the revision which we have done about the lesson number 9, trade. What we have studied in the first session, that also we have done. And what we have studied today, that also we have revised it. And now there is the evaluation part here. Yes, the first question you can see. Answers you have to write it in your own words, or you can take the help of your textbook also. First, you can see create a flowchart showing the types of trade. Yes, just now we have studied about the types of trade. You have to draw the flow chart over there. Just they have said there, draw the flow chart of showing the types of trade. They didn't say to explain it. You just have to draw. Then you have to explain the different types of balance of trade. There are three types of balance trade. Then state the objectives of WTO, means the World Trade Organization. There are some objectives, means aims and functions are there. These are the objectives of World Trade Organization. Then here, what is the difference between OPAC and APAC in terms of their functions? Here you have to describe their aims, both of OPAC and APAC. Their functions, their organizational functions are different over that. You have to mention here point wise. Then write the functions of the important trade organization in Asia. This also, you have to study the main, all the economic organization of the world in detail. Then you will be able to write the all the functions of it. What is the importance of marketing from farmers' point of view? Means whatever the importance of marketing, what we have studied just now, point wise, that you have to write it according to the point of view of from farmers. Yes, I hope you have you have get all the questions which is there on your screen. So I hope students, you will be able to write all the questions in a very good way with good explanation. So please try to write all the questions as a revision based. And I hope you have I hope you have understood this lesson. So thank you students for listening. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Pradhana Madam.